Alright, very nice split by Phaser. Hello. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome. This is another Stoles League game. This is game 5. And we have Phaser, the yellow Protoss representing Team The Dark Side from the Legion gaming community, spawning up in the top right position of GSL Daybreak. In the bottom left position, we have Nulltarget, the orange Protoss, representing Team, what is it called? StarCraft Honduras. That's right! S-C-H-N-D. Good luck, have fun, players. Excuse me. Both players kind of putting their pylon very close to their nexus instead of using it near their ramp in order to get that early wall off started. But as we were seeing in another match that I saw recently where one player was doing that and the other one was putting it near their ramp, they do it so that the pylon is closer to the mineral line, so that the probe is not off the line as much. Come on, Schumann, why do you need to lag every game? This heresy is going on YouTube. Yes, yes you did. You did. Everyone will know. Everyone in the whole freaking world. So bad. Okay, so the first gateway and the assimilator is down for Phaser, and same with Nulltarget. Gotta love mirror matchups. They are dead even on probes. Actually, Nulltarget is a little bit behind. There we go. Now he's at 15 probes. Gonna get that next pylon. And meanwhile, Phaser's is already almost completed. There it is. Nulltarget does scout him. Sees that he's a pylon ahead. Very nice. Puts the cybernetics core down there just to make it a little bit more difficult for Nulltarget's dastardly little probe to get in. And whatever else he might have in store. Instead, he's going to start zapping the gateway, but the gateway may be building a unit at some point. He's actually got the rally point on the probe, so that when he decides to build a zealot, which he's going to start right now, it will go after that probe. And then it will die. Okay, so the cybernetics core is finished for Phaser, and it is going to be finished for Nulltarget as well. There's the warp gate research going down immediately. Same with Nulltarget. Whoopsie! Might have been a little bit of a misclick there by Null attacking his own buildings. There we go. With 3 swipes, that zealot takes out that probe. Both players building their first zealot, or their first stalker, I should say. They've already got their zealots on the field. This probe is scouting everywhere. Is he going to hide an expansion up here? Looks like he might be. Yeah, the colors are pretty similar. Okay, so Phaser is going to move out with this zealot and stalker, and I wonder if Nulltarget's going to do the same. No, he's actually going to sit on his ramp and hold up a solid defense. Good stuff. We do have a Stargate going down for Phaser, as well as another couple gateways. So, 3-gate Stargate? That is the new build. Sentry at the top of the ramp for Nulltarget. How are the worker counts doing? 23 to 22, so Nulltarget's just only slightly ahead. And he's actually going to put down a Stargate of his own. When did this become standard PvP? What happened to everybody four-gating? Anyway, I just wanted to take a look at the APMs real quick. Nulltarget's actually very behind, but he could be spinning it very efficiently. He's got 59 APM to 90 of Phaser. I just like to look at the APM just to see how crazy the players are bashing on their keyboards trying to get these commands out. We do have... is that a second Stargate? No, it's still the first one. He has a robotics facility as well. There is a robotics facility going down for Phaser as well. Awesome. And I say as well a lot. There we go. First Phoenix on the field for Phaser. The first Phoenix is being built for Nulltarget. Okay, as far as mirror matchups go, this is not what I'm used to seeing. Protoss versus Protoss, it's usually like who can build the faster Forgate. This is like, I don't know. I don't know what I'm seeing. Anyways, I think I might be missing some action here. There are a couple of Phoenixes in the base of Nulltarget. The Phoenixes are just kind of picking on each other. Yep. This one's out of shields, but not terribly damaged. Yeah. Three Phoenixes for Phaser. Gonna turn on the health bars just for a little bit. And there's an Immortal coming up for Phaser as well. Very nice, filling those little gaps in the probe line with pylons. So this is all completely walled off now. Looks like Nulltarget is getting a Twilight Council. Finally, a little bit of a deviation between these two players. There are two Phoenixes in the base of Phaser by Nulltarget, but Phaser's Phoenixes are actually right here, and he's going to be able to chase this Phoenix out of his base. Yep. One Phoenix on its own cannot do really anything, especially when there's when the other player is using mostly ground units right now. Mostly ground units. He's got like five Phoenix, but I meant to say, sorry, that only one Phoenix cannot do anything to a mineral line because he cannot lift them in order to pick them up. Aha! There we go. That makes a lot more sense. One Phoenix from Nulltarget does get picked off by Phaser. Yep, that's not gonna last, sir. I'm sorry. What is up here? There's actually a proxy pylon by Phaser up by the third. And what is this? Oh, that's the probe. Alright. He does see that Nulltarget has not actually taken his expansion yet. Oh, stop lagging. And meanwhile, he's going to start taking his own. Take a look at the units. 28 probes to 23 for Phaser. So Phaser is 5 probes behind, and he's going to get his Twilight Council. Meanwhile, Nulltarget is already working on Blink, and it's just about finished. Looks like, ooh, he looks like he might have lost a Phoenix there. Maybe a couple. There are enough Stalkers here in order to handle it. And he's chronoing out that Blink tech. Very nice. A Templar Archive going down as well. Alright, that one hero probe getting out of there when he notices the expansion goes down. This observer coming into the base of Nulltarget by Phaser to see what's going on. Still flying around the map with these Phoenixes. The food count is pretty much dead even right now. Both players getting a Templar Archives. I'm not sure what's gonna happen. I don't know. I'm not familiar with this build, let alone watching two Protoss do basically the same thing for 10 minutes. And I'm not seeing what sort of army composition they're both going for. It looks like Phaser's getting Zealot Legs instead of Blink. Nulltarget has already finished his Blink. And these Phoenix are still trying to do harass. Alright, Nulltarget chronoing out some probes at his expansion. Trying to get that economy going. Yeah, he's still got half the APM of Phaser. There we go, he's bringing down more probes, trying to saturate his net. There's actually like four Stalkers in the main base of Nulltarget, just to defend against these Phoenixes that do seem to like to go in there and cause trouble. There's an Obs moving out from Nulltarget. And it looks like Phaser might be finally moving his army out. He's got four Immortals. That's pretty critical. Immortals are so OP. If you're going to call something OP, I don't know. It might as well be these guys. Short unrelated anecdote. I did a mono battle recently where I got Immortals. I managed to send out about 3 immortals with my buddy's stalker army, and my 3 immortals made the difference against a much larger army. So what immortals can do, they can be integral, key, just the wild card in a fight. There we go, he does get an Archon. Yeah, he's warping in High Templar 2 at a time and merging them. He does not have Psystorm, so I don't think that's in the future. There is a bit of a battle here. I'm sorry, he did pick up this one Zealot, but he's not attacking it with these other Phoenixes. Oh! That would be why. Okay. This one Obs moves in the base from Nulltarget and sees absolutely everything. Although it's pretty much what he's got in his own base, he can just look at his own base and figure out what's going on. Sees that maybe he's got one gateway on him, or 3 gateways on him, so he builds 3 more. I don't know, but here's an attack. Very nice, picking up the immortals with the phoenixes. Lots of force fields going down to try and block the Zealots. The Zealots do have charge. They managed to get in there, and he does lose them all. The Immortals are trying to pick off the Stalkers one at a time. They are doing quite a bit of damage. Some reinforcements coming in from Phaser. Look at these Hero Immortals. 6 kills. 3 kills. This one Immortal with 8 kills. Just wasting Stalkers left and right. Only 4 shots from an Immortal will waste a Stalker. And that is going to make the difference, like I said. Yeah, that could have been a much superior army, but the Immortals do a lot of damage to those Stalkers. And the Zealots, yep, there's the GG.